Good morning, gladiators. We who are about to play, salute you! Hey, everybody, how you doing? This is Oliver Joyce, a.k.a. The Games Gladiator. You know, moonlighting is The Games Gladiator. I don't do this much anymore, but every now and again, we like to fire up a game. And today's game is a fun one. I think the helmet is a pretty accurate representation of what the game is, because we're playing the totally accurate battle simulator today, which is crazy. It's like it's a weird physics battle thing where just crazy stuff happens. It's from Landfall Games, and this totally accurate battle simulator has 98,000 positive reviews on Steam, sitting at 98% as well. Something crazy. It is a massive success. It's been out for about 2 years now, and it's on the Xbox Game Pass, so I'm going to check it out this morning. Let's jump right in. Grab your sword, grab your sandal, and prepare for a hell of a ride. Here we are. Totally accurate battle simulator. And the title screen is different very often. It has that sort of low poly feel that you sort of feels a bit almost like an asset store game from Unity or something. But do not let the graphics fool you, because this is a wild ride. You've got all these different options. You can create custom content. You have a Steam Workshop. You've even got a multiplayer mode and a campaign and a sandbox to do whatever you want. What we'll do, how will we start? Let's start off. I just want to show you what this is all about. So we're going to do let's do the campaign. Let's do the introduction. Introduction to the game. All right. Clubs. So literally, enemies appear on this side of the map, and you're on this side of the map. And you can choose these characters. You have 600 gold to spend, and you can either buy clubbers, protectors, or spear throwers. There are all different eras to play through as well. There's, you know, this is the caveman era, but you have medieval and pirates, and even like a spooky theme and sort of modern military and stuff like that. Let's put a couple of these guys in. Every time I put one down, your money goes down a bit. Couple of them, put a few protectors in front, protect them, and a spear thrower at the back. And let's see how that goes. Ready? So then you basically watch the battle, so you can kind of zoom in on the battle and look. So it's going to be interesting. Our protectors aren't, they do help. You got these. It's got that classic jiggly physics where everyone sort of is like fighting against gravity the whole time. Hey, we're victorious. Excellent. Now they have a bunch of spear throwers, so we need to defeat them. This is teaching the strategies of the game, so we'll put a couple of protectors up. Then we need a couple of our own spear throwers right at the back, I reckon. But have I messed up? Get rid of one of each and put a couple of clubbers in there, because they seem to do the most melee damage. So it's this weirdly strategic game, even though you wouldn't think it. You don't have control once the battle starts, but how you place your troops and where you place them and the kind of troops you have makes all the difference. Look at these guys. They have these goggly eyes. They walk funny. He just got a spear in the back. These are our heroes way back in prehistoric times. I've got to show my boy Isaac this. He would love it. Okay. Isaac and I play a lot of games together. Charlie's still a little bit young. We put him on the couch with us, and he has a pretend controller. He does enjoy watching, but still a bit too young to master sort of the complexities of a mouse or even a gamepad. Now we're fighting a combination of characters. So we've got more troops as well. I'm really not sure what my strategy is, but that's been working in the past. But yeah, Isaac and I love playing games together. It's so cool having kids that like playing games as well. You know, we mold them in our own image, I guess. But we just finished Mario Odyssey as well, which is kind of cool. And, you know, Isaac even got a bunch of the stars in the game. The moon, sorry. Well, got him. Nice, easy one. So we'll do a couple more of these, and I'll show you something a little bit more complex. Okay, so they got a whole legion of interesting ones. Now we have access to new characters like the Bone Mage. Let's buy a Bone Mage and a couple of stoners. Stoners. A couple of Bill and Ted's, for those who get the reference. I quite like those protectors, because they do help a lot. So you need to space them out a little. They're clumped in. Okay. Let's roll with that lineup. I don't know what the Bone Mage does, but I'm guessing he's sort of like a necromancer. Let's follow. Those stoners are pretty cool too. They do a lot of damage. But are our shield guys getting a bit overwhelmed? No. What's the Bone Mage doing? Uh-oh, he's in trouble. This is going to be a closer battle, I think. Somebody help out the Bone Mage. He was expensive. Oh, are we going to lose? We were defeated. Let's try that again. Okay. Let's change our lineup a bit. A couple less of those. A couple less spearmen. And I'm just going to go with more clubbers. They don't have any ranged guys. So you can see why this is a popular game, because everyone loves a sandbox game. Everyone loves a, whoa, our club has got smashed. Okay, yeah, that's a bad combination. That's not going to work. We'll do it one more time, then I'm going to show you some other battle modes. So get rid of most of the clubbers. We're just going to fill it up with stone men and a couple of protectors. Okay, see, like, it's just fun to experiment. And, you know, it's something, it's the kind of thing that you can see going viral. It's perfect for YouTube. Multiplayer would be a blast, I can imagine. Come on, three. Is that, didn't they have one stone? Oh, no, they slowly respawn their stones. I'm yet to discover what the Bone Mage does, but hey, we smashed it that time. All right, now, okay, perfect timing. We're now in a different era. So you can see this is like a medieval village with a beautiful little river going on. You know, I mentioned the graphics earlier. They are sort of low poly, but there's a nice style to them, and it is a style that is popular with indies, but it is a quite a great style. Look, mammoth. Can we afford a mammoth? No, that would be cool though. Let us get ourselves a chieftain, because they look like they're probably pretty powerful. A couple of stoners and two protectors. I don't know what these guys are going to be like, but what are they? So there's guys with pitchforks. So if we can just hold them off a little longer, the protectors are good because they stall your enemy. And what did our chieftain do? Did our chieftain die? Well, I'm guessing we've won. Oh, there's one more to get. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a break, and then we're going to go back with a more detailed battle. I'll show you what this game is really capable of. And while I have you here, I just want to give a quick shout out to my hearty band of Patreon supporters. Welcome to Caden. Thanks for signing up, my friend. Great to have you aboard. We also have Dane Simino, Daniel Funches, Barty X, Brandon K, Ilya Gurevich, Pipuch, Noah Gudajan, Stone God, Timmy Boy, XUp Omega, Jeffro of Hex3D, Hopeless, and Eunice. I love seeing those names. They're a great bunch of guys, and I'm looking forward to sharing with them what's next on my next game. That's coming up. They'll find out before everyone else. So if you want to be a Patreon, the link is down below. And if you'd like to be a Patreon, where's my armorer? Ah, my armorer animation is gone.
That would still make my day.
Poor armorer. Budget cuts at Whiskey Barrel Studios. All right, so yeah, we're back now. Totally accurate battle simulator and a different title screen again. There was some kind of strange dinosaurs. Awesome. Okay, so let's do a sandbox. Okay, we have tribal sandbox, farmer, medieval, ancient cities, Vikings. Let's go with, let's try the Viking sandbox. Okay, we're on this sort of ice flow here. And you got access, you got basically unlimited money, and you can choose who goes on either side. So, what's that? Main simulation. Oh, wow. Let's do that next. Okay, so we're doing the Viking sandbox. I'm going to choose for this side, some farmers, Vikings. And, you know, it basically tells you how much each thing's worth. Some dynasty warriors. Oh, you can, oh, okay. All right. Okay. Let's trash everything. So these are the errors. The farmers. Let's go with like some wheelbarrow men, potion sellers, hay balers, farmers. These are the guys we had before. And they can fight some Vikings. And on the other side, we're going to have Viking warriors, a couple of brawlers, ice archers, berserkers, valkyries, a longship, and a jarl. Put a jarl up the front. And let's put a longship. See how it goes behind. All right. Pretty evenly matched, 9,000 points each. To battle, my friends. So the longship's fallen over. It's hard to know what's actually going on. That's the fun of it. Someone's cast an ice spell of some kind. The hay balers are kind of cool. Wow, the Valkyries are pretty devastating. Blue team won. Okay. What I'd like to go, let's go back to the main menu. And we'll do another computer simulator one because that's kind of fun. We will do a campaign one because I think that's. Let's do a simulation one actually. Bridge battle. Okay. So with the bridge battle, I did this when I was testing out this game before. You basically have to take down these knights on the bridge. You've got to stop them somehow with, and you've got 5,000 points to spend. It's really hard. I tried it before. So we have. What are the Wild West guys? Cactus? Let's put some cacti up. We'll have some lasso men. They're expensive. Dynamite throwers. Bunch of them. Couple of miners. This is gonna be, and maybe gunsling. We can't afford. I should take off one of the miners. I can afford a gunslinger. He's our last line of defense. And Deadeye would have been cool too, but all right. I don't think this is going to work personally, but let's try it out. So now you have these knights charging across the bridge. They've run into the cactuses, and that's hurt them, but they have made absolute mincemeat of the other guys. We were stomped before everyone else got there. So that's not going to work with the Wild West troops. Trash them. Let's try Renaissance troops. Jousters. Trying to mix them, meet them at their own game. A couple of balloon archers. Oh, a Da Vinci tank. Can't quite afford that. Halberdiers. Some balloon archers. You know, there is so much strategy to be had that, you know, we haven't done. See if the jousters will meet and maybe cancel each other out because they did a lot of damage. They fall off into infinity. Oh! But now you got these shield guys who outnumber us. The balloon archers are hilarious. They give people balloons and then the balloons go flying up into the sky. This combination is doing okay. Uh-oh. You got these kind of Spartan troops here that might be too much. That we're not gonna win, but that did better. Ah, this is brilliant. It is such a great game. Okay. All right, what we'll do is we're gonna go out of that scenario. This is the fun thing about it. It's just a sandbox and you can have so much fun with. There's a Halloween scenario here. We will do spooky. What do you reckon a spooky campaign will be like? Boom. So we're in some kind of graveyard and we have access to all the different kind of troops, but what haven't we tried yet? Dynasty Warriors, who are sort of like Asian dragons. Monkey King. Can't afford a Monkey King. Let's get some firework archers back here. Gotta have samurai. And fighting monks. Oh, I didn't get a ninja. Cancel on that. Gotta have a ninja. Can't win that without a ninja. All right. See if our brave Dynasty Warriors can. Whoa, that's awesome. It's hard to kind of see what's going on half the time, but if you sort of focus on one or two troops and zoom in, I'm controlling the camera here. They're great. These Skeleton Warriors are pretty powerful. Someone is. I don't know who's doing it, but they were creating fireworks. Hey, don't run away. Oh, they get scared. Did we lose? We lost. Okay. Try it again with... What happened when we use pirates? Okay. Let's get a couple of blunderbuss. Some flintlock pirates. Bomb throwers right at the back. Oh, a captain. I wonder if I need a more powerful troop. Let's see where these guys go anyway. Sort of depends, you know. The blunderbuss obviously probably a very slow gun. I think we probably need something more melee than these guys. Oh, hey, we won. So it looked like the munitions department did a great job. Now, we both have to stay on this side of the center. We're going to try ancient warriors now. So, oh, maybe we're in the middle. They're surrounding us. Okay. Oh, Minotaur. Let's get ourselves a Minotaur. Oh, Zeus. There's so many great choices. Get some hoplites. So surround him. Some hoplites. Cirruses are spear throwers. Can we afford them? Shield guys. Oh, I should have put more of them. Get the shield wall going. Classic Spartan. Alright, ready? Let's go. Being attacked on all sides. And they've even got skeleton archers and everything. Where's our Minotaur? Is he causing trouble? Oh yeah, he's absolutely tearing up that. No, he fell off the hill. So we spent a lot of money on the Minotaur. And that did not pay off at all. We got absolutely worked. Okay. What? Oh, no, he's still fighting. He's still fighting over there. But even he may not be enough. He's fighting the cliff over here. Look at this. Get up. Get up, big fella. So he is probably, he's definitely worth it because he's so powerful and he's even almost single-handedly winning this battle. But that was because, what if we got, we'll try that one more time. What if we got two Minotaurs? Like, it's kind of twin thing. I love the strategy behind this. There's so much, a couple of shield bearers to protect them. No, snake archers. Ballista. Can't afford a ballista. We can almost afford one. Zeus would be awesome as well. What about a Minotaur and Zeus? Oh, a lot. There's so many combinations. I love it. Okay, let's just go with a couple of hoplites. Okay, go. I highly recommend this game. It was on Xbox Game Pass, but you know, whatever platform you get it on, this is unlimited fun to be had. It's the kind of game that you think, whoa. You think, oh man, I wish I'd made that. That's a sign of a good game. Something you can say, damn, I wish I'd made that. This is beyond my technical skill to make something like this at the moment. I am going to learn 3D. This is my next task for my next game, 3D. Because I would love to make this kind of thing. You know, I think there's just a lot of potential to be had. Hey, look, this Minotaur is still dominating. Where's our other Minos? Here we go. Up you get. Hey, don't... The problem is on this battlefield, they can fall, and he's fallen to his doom there, but that Minotaur, if you can stay upright, avoid the janky physics, then you may be successful. Come on, you can do it, buddy. Get up! Victory! Okay, cool. We gotta have another game. Alright, last game, and then I gotta call it a day, because I gotta do some work. Medieval. Okay, so we're gonna... they got some... interesting looking guys there. Looks some kind of spell casting lineups. We're gonna go with 4,000. One catapult, which could be risky, but some two knights. King, cool. King would probably be powerful as well, but would you have 10 archers or a king? Let's go. A squire, two, but yeah, gotta have a bard. Speaking of bards, go see the D&D movie. Awesome. I underestimated it, I gotta tell you. And that's the most fun I've had in the cinema in a long time. It's just classic Dungeons & Dragons adventure. I saw it with my good buddy Greg Wee, who is the inspiration for Sir Belgrave. And we used to play D&D all the time. And, you know, this movie, it's got a lot of heart. It's fun. Doesn't take itself too seriously, but it's not sort of like... Hey, cool. you know, but it's doesn't feel like a Marvel movie. It's just a good adventure. Kind of has a bit of a Princess Bride sort of vibe to it. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the spooky campaign. I'm going to do one more battle. I keep saying one more, but it is that kind of game where you want to have one more battle. Let's do a massive sandbox on a medieval battlefield. And we're just going to go crazy. I'm going to test out my computer and make the fan go wild. So we're going to put a whole bunch of troops. This is some good and evil. So we'll put some evil guys here. A bunch of them. Just crazy lich. Void monarch. Even some like, can't get those ones yet. Peasants. Get a bunch of peasants. Just because I really want to pack the numbers in. This will probably slow things down quite a lot. Let's put like a bunch of ninjas. Even a dragon. Massive dragon. Can I fit a dragon? No, I can't fit a dragon there. Huacha. The Huachas are cool. Like, almost like a machine gun of arrows. Deadly. Monkey kings. Samurais. Okay, that's on that side. That is an 81,000 piece army. And on this side, we're going to have tons of berserkers, a bunch of Jarls, headbutter at the front. We're gonna have some ancient warriors. We're gonna have Zeus, a couple of Minotaurs because they were awesome. We're gonna see what other things. Let's also throw in some mammoths. Was that a mammoth? No, that was a Minotaur. I didn't click the mammoth. Oh, they're big. Look how big they are. The big googly eyes. We'll also get some quick draws. These guys can hang here and take out people from the sides. Because, you know, you never know when you need a cowboy in a battle. All right. That's only 23,000. Okay, we have a lot more to spend. Let's go to the good side then. Let's see if we can get some sacred elephants next to the mammoths. Divine Arbiter, what are they, like angels? I don't know. Righteous Paladins? The Paladin in the D&D movie is amazing. Celestial, they gotta be angels. Cool. Chronomancers, must be like a wizard. Devout Gauntlet. I'm just putting in random troops from everywhere. And you gotta have Balloon Archers. I'm running it, what's expensive? Da Vinci Tank? Da Vinci Tank? No, put that right at the back. Wow. It's really, this game is just the kitchen sink. It truly is the kitchen sink. Oh, that's the spooky one. Bunch of Reapers. Okay, now we're about even. Put a couple of Reapers on this side as well. Get ready. This is going to really chug. My computer's about 5 years old. It had a good video card at the time. But look at the slowdown. Even I'm talking slow. And I can't really tell you what is going on. The Huacha is absolutely tearing up in the distance. The mammoths are dead. The elephants have fallen off the cliff. I don't know if any gunslingers have lived. This winged... Yeah. Who's winning? Are we winning? Are we losing? I guess I'm assuming we're the red team. The Da Vinci Machine. Oh, you gotta love it. It's like a theoretical Da Vinci tank there. Well, the red team won, so I'll take that as a victory. That's awesome. That is absolutely awesome. All right, well, Landfall Games, I take my hat off to you. That is one hell of a game. It is literally the totally accurate battle simulator and absolutely just a blast. It's something I would come back to many times. I had fun today. I can see why it has 98,000 reviews, and these guys must be rolling in money. And, you know, I'm in awe. That's it for the Games Gladiator today. I'll be back next time with another game. We'll see. Thanks for joining me. These are always fun. It's been a nice little break from doing Swords and Sandals, mobile conversions, and that kind of thing. I'm starting on my next game in May, so about a week or so. Fingers crossed. It's been a huge delay, but I can't wait to get stuck in. I am, of course, Oliver Joyce. I hope you will subscribe to my channel if you like games and, you know, game dev and all sorts of things, Swords and Sandals. If you're new to the channel, welcome. For those who are back, good to see you. Until next time, my friends, bye for now.